All right, good morning. Good afternoon, good evening. It's Tragic Life here. We are still dealing with Victory Road. We got quite a bit left. I would have finished the level 2 of this, or the floor 2, but I hit the wrong button, and didn't feel like going back. So, without further ado, we're going to leave off where we should have left off if I wouldn't have hit that wrong button. It is 2 o'clock in the morning here on the 7th, so I'm a bit tired. Usually I don't wake up till, I don't generally get on here till 6 a.m., but they needed me to come in early to work, so here I am. So we should have been grabbing this here, which was a full heal. So we're going to go ahead and continue. So here it says, if I follow, let's go down the ladder. No, follow the linear path to the northeast, and we should run into. Oh, that's not it. That self-destruct is just rude. Is Victory Road too tough? He wants to fight. Oh. So this juggler has 25% chance of switching out active Pokemon. Never mind. Can't really switch out active Pokemon when you don't have any. But if he did. I would say don't keep doing that to me. Well done. Okay, so in here is going to be TM17. I'm just randomly doing this, by the way. I mean, that works. Wasn't sure if that's what that meant or not. Alright, let's try again. TM17, which is Submission. This was also available to buy at Celadon Department Store long ago, and contains Submission, the most powerful fighting-type move in the game. Well, available via TM anyway. Though that isn't saying much. It has 80 power, which is decent, but only has a 79.7% accuracy and a terrible side effect of causing damage to the user. Despite these drawbacks, it can be worth it using on a fighting type Pokemon as a strong move. It can also be learned by a wide variety of Pokemon, which might find it useful dealing with bulky normal or ice type. Alright. Yeah. My controller was off for a second. I think it's this ladder here. Alright, head northeast. Man, they're self-destruct. Okay. Northeast. I heard rumors of a child prodigy. Okay, so this CoolTrainer has a 25% chance of per turn or using X attack on active Pokemon. He can use it up to 2 times a Pokemon. Cool. CoolTrainer sent out Executor. Nope, nope. Oh, that's no. Okay, we get it. Red body flap. Alright, you really like your barrage. This guy's a pain in the butt. Wake up. Can I wake up now? Not a big fan of fighting Cloyster. Cloyster can be dangerous. That's gonna suck. Oh great, you're gonna hit really hard. I'm a plant. Ouch. No, close. Well, goodbye, Arcanine. Were true. Okay, so we should get a max revive here, which is perfect because we're gonna use this. We're gonna use a revive on Pidgeot.
Okay.
We don't have to leave. Okay, oh, excuse me, guys.
I told you it's early.
Okay, this explosion thing that they keep doing is becoming a major threat. So, yeah. Let's just push it off. Are they all gonna use explosion? Holy crap, at least that one did blow up. Okay, we push it up here, but do not push it to the roof. Because we're gonna push it down. If I understood this correctly. That's exactly what it did. It exploded. So I'm not even getting any points for fighting them. So I think from now on with Pidgeot, I'm just gonna run from those. So this should be TM-47, which is explosion. This is another unique TM, and the most powerful move in the entire game. It is a normal move with a massive 170 power, although it is effectively 340 power since it halves the target's defense stat as well. This huge power comes at the cost of making the user faint, though, causing it to lose out on any experience and might have earned for defeating the opponent. Explosion is an extremely good option for competitive play as a last-ditch nuke, and can similarly be used in cartridge play if you wish, but often the opponents in this game are weak enough that they never necessitate such drastic action. Remember that as a normal-type move, explosion does not work on ghosts. So I messed up, and I'm gonna fix it now. Alright, so push it here. Through here, you can go meet the Elite Four. Okay, I mean, Bring it, buddy. Bring it. What's the fight? What do you got?
This could be a fight.
We're gonna fly.
Well, I was hoping for that. Didn't expect that, but I was hoping for that.
Okay, use a lap.
Is that water one? I think that's a water one.
I was right.
Give me another one. No. Right, am I gonna survive this?
No. We did well.
No, we'll keep our glue. Oh, hi, that was cool.
No, unbelievable.
Yeah, I feel you. All right. An ultra ball and a guard spec. So we're gonna go ahead and use a revive again. However, we are going to switch our Pokemon real quick. And I'll be right back. Alright, we're back. We have a Moltres. So you, alright, so I'm gonna try to catch him for you guys. No promises. These have always been a pain in the butt. First thing is trying not to let it kill you. This one's supposed to be the weakest of the group. It's also rated C, but we'll get to that once I catch him. First things first, let's put him to sleep. Please work. Okay, that was a waste of time. We're not going to catch him at this rate. Stay asleep. Fingers crossed. Ha ha, you guys never get to watch me catch it, huh? Ha ha ha, we got him. Cool. So he's rated C. He's a legendary bird, but he's too late to be useful. Mediocre type typing and poor move will make it much less useful. While it has high stats and a good level 50, it still has shaky matches for the remainder of the game. Legendary bird Pokemon, as it flaps its flaming wings, even the night sky will turn red. No. Okay, that's awesome. Alright. I'm back upstairs. We're not gonna do this video for too much longer, guys, but we're gonna do a little bit more. I mean, that's awesome, but I was really getting used to using. I'm gonna try to fight the next two trainers. Alright, don't use Pidgeot against them, because boy, that was a waste of time. Alright. So this one has a 100% chance of using a Hyper Potion if its Pokemon is below 10%, or switching out to the next unfeinted member of the party if it's between 10 to 20% of its maximum HP. She can only use Hyper Potion once per turn, and once she does, she can't switch out or use another one. Trainers live to seek stronger opponents, do they? Well, you've met this. I said two more trainers, I meant actually the next three. If I can, we'll see. You gotta get to work. Although, it won't take me long to get there because there'll be almost no traffic. Okay. We're gonna go and fly. I was hoping for that. I need to level this character up. Hey! As I was speaking. Alright, Dewgong, that's another water one. Oh, Omaster is probably a stupid choice. But I think he has other attacks. We haven't used. Let's try a spike again. Okay, that's a waste of. Try water gun, I doubt it's gonna do any good damage. We're gonna use growl. Or surf. Seems to be a strong attack when others attack spell. Okay. So we're gonna switch out. Butterfree. I wasn't expecting that. Can you take him out? Did you really? Can I find a pickable? This is this. Well, this is making it seem like we're not going to fight more than... This might be the last one we fight because he's becoming a pain in the butt. Don't miss. Okay, I do not like Chansey. It doesn't do any damage, it just ruins my life. Really? No. At this point, I just want to end it. Are you serious? Are you serious? Don't you wipe me. Okay, come on. Oh, it's still on. I'm not, though. Wow. This trainer has been dangerous. I talked too soon. I'm gonna win, but it's... wasn't expecting you to headbutt me. Okay. Well, we won. Jeez. I like to gain a lot. Ash defeated CoolTrainer. Oh, so strong. Okay, so I think this is where we're going to end it. I'm going to go ahead and use a escape rope. Boy, I think I just got my butt kicked. Sheesh. That was crazy. Yeah, that was crazy. I don't think we got much left. Hello. No, we're almost done with the... We're almost done. We've got really... Dang, we're almost done. So, well, until next time, we'll finish it finally. Alright, bye guys.